Have you ever watched someone else's edit and thought, this is the most amazing video I've ever watched? It's unique, it has crazy visuals, it's perfect. And then 2 seconds later, you're like, why is my edit so bad compared to this? Like, you get inspired, you grind for hours, but no matter how many effects you try, no matter how many tutorials you watch, your video just doesn't hit the same. I went through the same thing. And it's only after years that I realized what was holding me back. That single secret that I was missing was my taste.
Brother, this guy stinks!
Sounds pretty boring, right? But that's exactly why I wasted so much time ignoring it. Because I thought taste was something you're born with. Like, some people are just naturally gifted and the rest of us are supposed to struggle forever. But recently, I wanted to take my videos to a whole new level. So I went down the rabbit hole of trying to find out what taste actually is and how anyone can build it. And what I found is that making something appear tasteful is quite easy, actually. And it all comes down to the 5 core principles I'm about to show you in this video. And once you know this, you can finally start to create videos that feel unique to you and videos that people will not stop watching. Chapter 1. Consistency. If you want your videos to have taste, first we have to study the top creators and why people love their videos so much. What I noticed is that the thing that sits at the core of their videos is always consistency. Consistency when it comes to the style and music choices. Basically, finding a brand identity that you can follow for all your videos. Daniel Dallon does it with his color grading and visuals, MrBeast does it with his visuals and fonts too. And now I do this too with these pixel animations. So find a style that resonates with you. Set simple rules for yourself, like my videos will use orange as the primary color and stick to that. And try to create this branding bit by bit as you're editing the videos. But there's a deeper level to all of this. There's also the music you choose. I suggest you create a playlist for yourself with the same music style, sort of like creating a soundtrack for your video. An easy one I recommend is Synthwave. That's what I personally used for a long time in my clients' videos. And after you create your own brand identity, you can create presets and assets for yourself. What I did for my videos, I made a collection of transitions, backgrounds, overlays, and I just always use those in my videos. I even went as far as creating text presets with custom animation, so I can quickly just drag and drop them, change a few settings, and add the animation in like 30 seconds. And to not feel that I was being restricted by them, I added so much customization to the point now where I don't have to open After Effects anymore. I can make all of the complex text animations that I make in After Effects inside Premiere with a simple click. I did the same thing for backgrounds, for my videos and for my clients' videos. Because everyone has their own branding and I don't want to search hours and hours to find a good background, I can just change a few settings and I always have a new background that looks entirely new and I know it fits my style. And because I wish I had something like this when I first started out, I packaged all my assets that I use into one pack, the Ultimate Creator Toolkit. It includes all the text and background presets I mentioned, plus overlays, transitions, sound effects, and customizable CTAs where you can just drag and drop your client's profile picture, change the colors through these sliders. I'm constantly making updates to this pack as I'm making new stuff for myself, like this one new transition that you see. And if you want to get access and download my entire editing pack, check the link in the description below. Now that we've got consistency out of the way, let's move to clarity. Every moment where the viewer gets confused gives them an opportunity to click off. Because a second someone feels confused, their brain just has to work harder just to follow along. People now are used to watching reels and scroll for hours. So now if your video takes extra effort for them to understand it, they will be instantly off your video and back to the doom scroll. Taste isn't about just what you like. It's about what feels right and what doesn't. Editors with bad taste often throw all the effects they know on the timeline because they can't tell when it's too much, and that instantly makes their video feel bad. Look at this scene from my YouTube video where I explained how contrast creates impact. If the game sets a pattern and then breaks it, suddenly you're on the edge. You don't know what's coming next. And that's when fear hits.
What is that? What's happened? Why is everything... Yeah.
Now imagine I just cut off the long pause right before the jump scare. It would instantly ruin the point and make the viewer feel confused. That's what clarity means. Knowing what you want to create first. And as a rule, never overcrowd your visuals. That isn't even about taste, but I had to mention it because I know I did this a lot when I was just starting out. And now that you understood the basics of making something easy to watch, now we can get into the more advanced editing tips. Chapter 3. Flow. This means knowing how to pace your videos and how to make your visuals flow together. This matters because you don't want your videos to feel boring. And if you want your videos to be tasteful, it needs to be entertaining too. Otherwise, you just spend a bunch of time working on a video that people won't even watch. Your videos need to feel like an experience, not a lecture. You need to make your viewer feel excited because they clicked on your videos. Then 20 seconds later, make them reflect on something. Then make them feel motivated, constantly changing your video's vibe. And the best tool you can use to help you is music. Here's how to do it. This is the timeline of my last video. As you can see on this 6-minute video, I have 13 different songs. Why I do that? Because each section feels different. And I know a problem that some of you may encounter is how to smoothly transition between songs. These are the two techniques that I know. The first one is to find a point where you can skip a part of the song without people noticing. Let's just say I take this spot here and move it to the left. Okay, this is fine. Now let's crossfade so it feels even smoother. And that's basically it. The second technique is to make it end with a reverb. The way you do it is just cutting it, nesting it, make a duplicate inside the nest and scale it like this. Okay, let's now get back to the main sequence. Let's duplicate it and add this reverb on top. Set it to whole and you're done. Here's how this one sounds. Now, how do I make my visuals flow together? First, I need you to do something. Try reading this text on the screen. You see, if the words line up, your eyes glide across the words, and it's super easy to read them. Even if I smoothly move them off the center, it's still easily readable. But if one word is randomly way off, now your eyes have to jump around and just makes the whole experience uncomfortable. Apply the same principles in your own edits, and make sure your viewer doesn't have to look all over the screen to find where he should look at. Here's one extra thing you should do. If one shot pans in, the next shot should also pan in. If one shot slides left, then the next one should also slide left. This is so the transitions between your shots look natural and professional. I mean, if you oversimplify the entire Apple style, is this. Flowing shots together smoothly and keeping the focus point in the same spot. In my opinion, this is what makes them so great, and that's what you should steal from them. Chapter 4, intention. Tasteful editing always feels on purpose. Every single visual that you add needs to have an intention. Here's my process for creating visuals. First, I choose a section that I know needs a visual. For example, let's take this one. Think about it. The viewer watches your video for 1 minute, maybe 2. But if there isn't something he can look forward to, he will feel like the video is just a waste of time and click off. I came up with this idea of a character walking on the timeline, walking toward the reward. Then when the reward gets removed, he stops and ends up clicking off the video. Then I got into the actual animating process. I tried to keep it as simple as possible. That's why I only added a few numbers, but keep the elements really simple. I realized it looks a bit empty and a bit too still for my taste. And that's why I added my face on top, so it fills up the empty space. And it makes it look much more professional and it doesn't take away from you understanding the animation. Then I played a bit with the visuals at the end to make it look even better. And that's it. Think about it. The viewer watches your video for 1 minute, maybe 2. But if there isn't something he can look forward to, he will feel like the video is just a waste of time and click off. As you can see, first I always make a very simple version of the animation, just to see if my idea is actually good and easy to understand. And only after I do that, I add the nice effects and all the other stuff. This way I don't lose time holding all these effects, only to remove it at the end because the animation wasn't good to start with. Chapter 5, personal touch. By now you learned the more technical things of what makes edits look great, but I want your videos to feel like your own and you to have your own personal taste. For that, you need to find things that you like. For example, I like games and storytelling. This is why in my videos I try to tell stories through my visuals and why I started doing these pixel art elements in my videos, because I personally love the game look of it, but I still follow the things we talked about in the first 4 chapters. Personally, I like to use Pinterest best to find inspiration for my videos. When you start to include things that you personally love, what will happen is that you'll find your audience that also loves the same stuff. And it will be much easier to edit because it's fun to add those small personal touches. This is how you create your own voice and your own taste as an editor. I actually made a full course where I show you how to create these game style animations, how I animate them, and the principles you need to know so you can start to create videos in this pixel motion style. So if you like this video and you want to see the exact step by step of what goes into creating a full scene like this, just check the link in the description to the pixel motion course. So now you've learned what taste really comes down to. Consistency, so your work has its own identity. Clarity, so your edits are easy to follow. Flow, so your edits feel like an experience, not a lecture. And intention, so everything feels on purpose. Taste isn't something you're born with. It's something you develop one edit at a time. And the more you refine it, the more your videos will stand out from everybody else's. And don't forget, if you want to either get the edit game pack or the course, you'll find the links in the description below. I hope this video helped you. See you next time. Peace.